you get the idea? I say, I read the Sumerian tablets, and that's what they say. They said that our solar system is made up of 12 members. And this is stated in the Sumerian text over and over and over again, not one time. And they say there is the sun, which is in the center, not like the Greeks or others thought that the earth is in the center, the sun. There's the moon, which they gave reasons why they considered it a member by its own. And 10, not 9, but 10 planets. Therefore, I'm very happy that when today astronomers look for this planet, they call it Planet X. They mean maybe the unknown planet, but it's also the 10th planet. They called it Nibiru, which means planet of the crossing, and the ancient symbol was the cross, not from Christian times, but from 6,000 years ago. And they say that this planet, the 12th member of our solar system, has a very large orbit of 3,600 years, and every 3,600 years it comes between Mars and Jupiter, close to us. And it is then, they said, that people, people that look like us, not with little horns or green, people they look that look like us, started to come between their planet and Earth about 450,000 years ago. Why do they look like us? We look like them. Because if you know the Bible, which is based on the Sumerian tales, at some point they engaged in genetic engineering and mixed their genes with the genes of Homo erectus, with the genes of various
such a vast improvement over the primates, we would have, 56 or 58 or maybe 60 chromosomes. How do you lose two chromosomes and get better? It really makes no sense. None of it. When you really just sit down and look at the very basics of it, none of it makes sense. We're not primates. We are not primates. To call us primates is to insult us and them, because there's just no connection. What could make something change so radically, literally overnight, in anthropological terms, and be anything remotely associated with Darwinism? I believe, personally, that the writings of the Sumerians 4,000 years ago, as chronicled by Zechariah Sitchin in his books, The Earth Chronicles, I believe that is the most logical and reasonable explanation that there is for how we came to be. They tell an incredible